The state senate is debating legislation that allows a computer system to determine who is eligible for bail or release at a court commissioner level.
If passed, it will completely overhaul half of the judicial system as we know it. 11 News reporter David Collins has that story. He joins us live from Annapolis. David.
Well, Donna, the legislation is in response to a high court ruling that poor defendants must have an attorney at the court commissioner level. Now, that would cost taxpayers an estimated $55 million. So lawmakers are scrambling to come up with a cheaper alternative that's acceptable to the courts.
Don't have a lot of faith in any of these things.
The Senate is struggling to do the right thing to address the state's high court ruling. The DeWolf versus Richmond case determined that every defendant, including the indigent, is entitled to a lawyer when they see a court commissioner. But supplying an attorney at the commissioner level could cost taxpayers as much as $55 million. The $14 million alternative is drawing criticism. It creates a new pretrial services division in the executive branch of government. A computer would use statistical analysis to determine whether the defendant should be confined, freed on bail, or simply released.
For some, there are concerns that we're dismantling the district court commissioner system.
I'm just looking for some kind of assurance based upon what you know about the tool that there's a likelihood of no scenario where someone would be released for a class one offense, a violent class one offense.
The new data-reliant approach would start as a six-month pilot program in several counties before going statewide. It would also require district court to operate 6 days a week. The computerized risk assessment tool is being pushed by Senator Brian Frosch, who says a variation of the system is being used successfully in several other states. It's touted as gender, race, and zip code neutral. The computer would analyze risk based on a series of background questions.
Any pending charges for number of prior misdemeanor convictions. Five is number of prior felony convictions.
Baltimore County Democrat Senator Bobby Zirkin opposes. He wants voters to consider amending the state constitution to overturn the court's ruling.
If you're asking whether there are going to be mistakes made, the answer is yes, there will be. There are mistakes made today. And the fact is that we can predict, I think, with pretty good certainty, that there'll be fewer mistakes made by using this device.
The full Senate really seems to be having a tough time grappling with this issue. Today's discussion resembled a tutorial. They've already delayed taking final action on this bill, and they'll take it up again tomorrow. Reporting live from Annapolis, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.